My name is Ilana Well.
I'm Lex Scott Davis.
And we are in the
Conspiracy Corner.
That was not going to be used. It's good. That's the best. That's a good.
I'm fine. I think that was a better one.
We should use it.
We're back. Conspiracy Corner. It's your boy Cal. There's no Frasier. There's no Angel this week, but don't worry about them. We've got two stars from The First Purge. It's out July 4th in theaters. We have Lex Scott Davis and Ilan Noel. Thank you guys for coming here. Really appreciate it.
Thanks for having us.
I'm a fan of The Purge. We were having a lively discussion about The Purge here. Were you guys fans of The Purge before you got into the movie?
Absolutely.
Yeah?
I was.
My family was. They knew a lot about it. They knew more about it than I was. And that's kind of like what pushed me into like doing it.
Oh, okay. Yeah. Okay. But you were a huge fan.
Oh, yeah. My favorite genre are like thrillers and psychological thrillers. So I'm always trying to see a scary movie.
Yeah.
Even the ones that are terrible, I'm like, let's watch it.
That's the thing. Horror and thrillers, that's one genre where you can just sit there and watch like B and C rated films.
Exactly.
And still, you know, pick out the trash that's going on it or whatever. So, you know, it's always good. But I mean, at least with this series, it's not only well done, but the underlining story about, you know, classism and social issues and whatnot. It's been good to see play out. It's called The First Purge. It's actually the fourth film, but we're going back to the beginning. Can you guys give anybody out there who isn't aware of The Purge a brief synopsis of what this film is going to be?
Well, this one is the prequel that sets you up to figure out how this purge night becomes a national holiday. Mm-hmm. And so, like you said, it's 12 hours where all crime is legal. And we see in this film how it was originally structured and where it was an experiment.
Mm-hmm.
And unfortunately, we were the people they experimented on.
Yeah. Yeah.
So because this day never existed before, you get to really get to know these characters.
Mm-hmm.
For who they are and their lives outside of this wacky night.
Yeah.
And the suspense of none of the characters involved ever partaking in a purge makes it that much more like gratifying to watch. Because we know, as purge viewers, what's about to happen. Whereas they don't know what to expect at all. So the suspense is at an all-time high.
Yes.
Do you guys see any parallels from the first purge and what's going on in society today?
The most frightening part of this movie for me is how grounded in today's times it is. Mm. Like some of the social issues, some of the circumstances we find ourselves in 2018 are what make it hard to, you know, watch, in my opinion. Yeah.
Now for you, Lex, you know, you being a Purge fan and just a horror fan in general, what was it like being actually in the universe and in the environment?
It was a learning experience because, again, it's my favorite genre. I had no idea how difficult it is to actually film terror.
Mm-hmm.
I think most of the character work, like you kind of said, was done, honestly, prior to getting to Buffalo. I think we had a very extensive audition process. Mm-hmm. And within that time was a lot of character work. Just trying to figure out who these people are outside of this day. Again, it's not a real thing for them at this moment in their lives. But to be in Buffalo, which definitely is an eerie place.
Oh,
no shade to people from Buffalo, but it's very eerie. It's nothing like the city where, you know, we're used to New York.
Yeah.
Other than that being eerie, the actual process for me wasn't as scary as I thought the process should be.
Okay.
So it was definitely just challenging for me because, again, this is the first time I've ever did anything like that.
Do you guys have any particular moments in the film or just scenes that were the hardest to develop?
For me, it was the like sort of the emotional scenes because my character, he has a lot of gravity. You know, he has to conduct himself in a way where people will listen to him.
Mm-hmm.
So there's not that much room for like catharsis and like emotion. So there are a few bits in there where I get to like sort of have those moments. And there's a couple fight scenes that I'm really excited about how people are going to respond to.
I guess the one question that comes up for a lot of people when they talk about The Purge, how they would react if The Purge was a real thing.
Right.
Would you not participate in The Purge if it was a real thing?
I think we've all given the hypothetical. Even since the beginning, the first movie that came out. Like, I remember talking to friends about, like, what would you do? And I'm like, I'd probably hide in the basement of the market, be eating. And, you know, like, something silly. Because I guess everyone always goes straight to murder.
Mm-hmm.
And it's like, that's not the only, come on. Well, don't you want to steal all the candy out the candy store?
Murder's obviously in the trailer, so that's the thing people go to, but... people might want to just get a bunch of video games, or, you know, they want some chills or something.
Kick
it. Like, you right. know, we, that would be me. You'd have to be stealth with it. Yeah. But I feel like I would be trying to get whatever the latest sneakers, latest video yeah. games, and then just trying to wait it out in a bunker or something. Mm-hmm. But
yeah. It's a couple houses I would egg.
Like
couple,
I respect that.
Couple cool, bad customer service people, people that don't use their turning signals. Like, it, I would have a list
yeah.
of houses I need to hit.
You know,
I would.
Too.
It wouldn't be violent. I'd like put toilets in their trees. I would do something like that, yeah. but, you know, I would make sure all the clubs in L.A. stay open till 4 a.m.
Oh, wow, that's a good
illegal.
One.
Right?
That's a good one.
Because 1:20, lights come on.
Like, nah, you're not closing today,
that's
fam.
That's such a good idea.
That's depressing.
Word, yeah, yeah.
So
that's
intelligent man right here.
I'm sticking to that.
That's the other thing. Is that something now, you know, you talk about egging a house. We only learn about the purge. It's one day, 12 hours. Mm-hmm. The other 364 days out the year, would you be looking at the house like, yeah? I'm gonna get your shit fam, watch.
The list. I would be prepared.
That's what's so sad about the whole concept, because you live in this entire year building these relationships with various people. And then you find out purge night, like, you was planning on killing me.
Yeah, facts. I thought we was cool. Yeah, yeah.
Exactly. So, because I did the first and the second one definitely had those.
Yeah. The real
so
stuff
sad.
Came out.
It's crazy.
So sad.
Now, you know, there were some people in our building that knew you guys were coming through. They wanted to hit you guys with some questions, but they couldn't be here, so they gave me the question.
Okay.
So we wanted to hit our bowl up and please play a game called Asking for a Friend. I'm gonna shake this up.
That's clever. You can pick four.
I'm being mysterious, like it's not only four of them in here. If you had only three things to survive the apocalypse, what would the items be, and who is on your survival team?
Good question.
Well, food.
100%.
As I've mentioned before, I'm
100%.
The one who eats. yeah. Shea Moisture products for
Ooh,
my
that's
hair.
Smart. Good that's one. Smart.
And maybe a mate.
Is this for me or what?
A mate. We need a mate, right?
I would,
person?
I need a Netflix account, right?
Facts.
I need some entertainment.
Like
but
a then
strong, now
you gotta
a get the TV good
to
book,
get the Netflix
be...
on.
That's the thing, because you're thinking, when you say Netflix, you
so
need...
So just three things, bro.
You need like that. You're talking strong Wi-Fi, a TV.
Yes, things that
Nah, you say Netflix that comes with it.
That all encompassing.
Yeah, nah, they didn't have no asterisks there. Netflix account.
Grab the next one.
This one's for you.
Does the NSA know how much Netflix I watch? I don't watch much. I watch a lot of HBO Go.
I wonder why.
The NSA.
I wonder why. Yeah. Respect that. Do you have to pay for your HBO Go, or do they? Is that in the contract?
See, there's so many things where I'm like, why should I be doing these things? I do pay for it, but now I might have some questions.
You might need to, I don't know if you holler at Issa. I don't know if there's someone.
Somebody. But yeah, I pay my little, I think it's $10 a month.
Yeah, it's not
you
it's
should
not
get
that crazy.
Benefits, you know?
Something. You would think, you like with the
some
employee
screeners.
Package yeah. or something. Yeah, some
yeah,
screen or something.
Some quick screeners. I put the little thing on my computer.
You have to. No, you gotta put a piece of tape on there. You gotta make sure you're walking cautiously by the cameras and everything, because they're watching.
I'll put the little thing on
You know there. What? I have that theory about certain public bathroom mirrors.
No word.
Do you notice like certain mirrors have this weird 3D
effect
going on?
Yeah.
I feel like it's one of those.
It could be.
You
like,
know,
like the ones they
when
have
they're on the other side of the mirror, like just watching you.
It'd be weird if it's someone
it's
actually
really weird,
sitting
right?
there. Like I'm gonna assume they have a camera recording everything, because if like some guy's sitting there for 12 hours, that's
or like department store dressing rooms. I always because it's certain mirrors. It's not every mirror, but if you need to pay attention, it's
now
it
you're
makes
gonna
me nervous.
Next mirror
Why
you see you're gonna.
No, I think about that sometimes too. Elevator mirrors for me, like. It's so egotistical, like somebody following me up 40 floors. But I'm thinking that too.
That's the thing. It's like, you know, am I crazy for thinking they watching me, or are they really
are
watching
they really
me?
Watching
you know?
Me.
One never knows.
The imagination, the brain, man. You can't win.
Yeah.
I was debating on putting this on earlier, but do not be in the comments talking about MAGA hats and all that stuff. This clearly says
the first purge,
July 4th. You can see these two. And a bunch of other amazing people. I even hear designers in the film.
Designer,
which is,
yes,
make
he has
a little
an appearance.
Cameo. Yep.
And two tracks in the soundtrack.
Oh, words.
Yes.
Yeah.
All right. Well, Conspiracy Corner, Elon, Lex, thank you for coming through.
Bye.
Really appreciate it.
Thank you.
Check us out. Let us know what you think in the comments, too. Who you purging on? We're out. Peace.